Good day to everyone. Today we will see how to run a 3-phase motor with a single-phase power supply. You know, many do not have 3-phase power, but due to various reasons, they may have to run a 3-phase motor, and also, there is a provision for that with single-phase power. For this, we need to have a 3-phase motor, and you will see U1, U2, V1, V2, and W1, W2 coil ends are connected to the terminals in the terminal box. What we need now is to turn the motor like this with a single phase connection. Let's see how this motor runs with 3-phase power first. This is the 3-phase line, and we need a 3-pole breaker for it. Further, you need a magnetic contactor with thermal overload relay. From the 3-phase supply, 3 lines are taken through the breaker to the power inlet points of L1, L2, and L3 on the contactor. Then, from the outlet points of T1, T2 and T3 of the overload relay, 3 lines are connected to the U1, V1 and W1 ends at the terminal box. Now, if you connect W2, U2 and V2 ends together, you will get the star connection of the windings for this motor. But since we get less current and less torque with a star connection, we need to go for delta connection here to get the best available torque from the single phase supply. Delta connection is shown here on the right side top, and you will see U1 W2 ends are connected together with the red color phase wire. You need the same at the terminal box also, and here it is shown highlighted with white color line. Then V1 U2 ends are connected with yellow color phase, and need the same to be done at terminal box also. Thirdly, W1 V2 coil ends are connected to the blue color wire at the bottom, and the same is shown highlighted at the right side end of the terminal box. To do this connection in the terminal box, we use 3 metal plates like this, and by connecting accordingly, you will see motor will start running. Now, the 3-phase line is not there. Instead, we have a phase wire and the neutral wire from the 230-volt single-phase supply. So we can replace the 3-pole breaker and connect a 2-pole breaker to the line. Now, phase line and the neutral line to be taken through the 2-pole breaker onto the L1 and L2 terminals of the magnetic contactor. Let's see the delta connection diagram again, and you will see U1 W2 coils ends are connected together, and the phase wire shown with red color is connected to this point now. Likewise, in the terminal box also, need to do the same, so the phase wire taken from T1 of the thermal overload relay connected to the U1 W2 ends, which are already joined together with a metal plate. Let's go to the delta diagram again, and you will see V1 U2 coil ends are joined together, and we will connect the neural line to this point. You will see the black wire is connected there and marked as neutral. At the terminal box also, V1 U2 coil ends are already joined with the metal plate and need the neutral line to be connected to it. Now, if you connect neutral line to the terminal box directly through the T2 terminal of the overload relay, motor will trip off. Overload relay will detect that there is no current flow through the T3 terminal and will trip off to protect the motor running with 2 phases. To avoid this situation, we use T2 outlet wire from overload relay as a jumper wire back to the L3 inlet line of the contactor, and then T3 outlet of the overload relay is connected to the V1 U2 ends at the terminal box. Now, you will see on the delta connection diagram, there is one point left without any connection, and is where the W1 V2 coil ends are connected together. We need to select the right capacitor for this motor now, and one end of it will be connected to this point. Other terminal of the capacitor is to be connected to the point where the phase wire is connected. Capacitor selection for the motor is to be done according to the power rating of the motor. 70 microfarad capacitor is to be connected for a motor with 1 kilowatt power rating. Capacitor microfarad value needs to be selected, as per the 70 microfarads, per 1 kilowatt ratio, according to the motor rating on the nameplate. This capacitor will run, with 90 degrees phase angle difference, related to the single phase voltage supply, and will operate this motor, with fairly balanced condition. Capacitor is connected now, to the points shown on the diagram, like this. Capacitor wiring on the terminal box 2, need to be done as per the diagram now, and one end of it, is connected to the U1W2 coil ends, where the phase wire is also connected. Other end of the capacitor, needs to be connected to the W1V2 coil ends, as per the diagram. You will see now, the motor is running, and is on the clockwise direction. All what you need to check now is, how to reverse the direction, of rotation of this motor. Here, what we need to do is, remove the capacitor wire end connected with the phase wire, and shift it to the point, where the neutral wire is connected. On the terminal box, I have highlighted these points, where the capacitor is connected. You will see now, the point connected to the phase wire, is shifted to the place, where the neutral line is. So, we remove the capacitor wire end, from the live wire end now, and is connected to the point, where the neutral wire is. You will see, the motor starts running, on the opposite direction now, and is the anti-clockwise direction. Always make sure, 3-phase motors should run, only with 3-phase supply connection, and you do this with a single-phase connection, in an extreme condition only, where you have no other option to run it. Hope you got the idea now, how to run a 3-phase motor, with a single-phase connection. If this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.